This video is based on the objective function calculation. Objective function, also known as cost function, fitness function, or evaluation function, that we use in meta-heuristic algorithm to check algorithm performance. For example, you can see here different types of test functions that we used in previous video to check algorithm performance. In this video, we will try to understand how we can calculate the objective function values for any meta-heuristic algorithm. Krill-Hurd optimization algorithm that we already discussed in the previous videos. Right now, in this video, we will try to understand how we can calculate the objective function values for Krill-Hurd optimization algorithm. First step is the parameter initialization phase. Here, we will initialize all the important parameters. For example, population size, that is the total number of search agents in the search space, maximum number of iterations, search space boundary, that is the lower bound and upper bound, and you can see the algorithm parameters, that is Krill's forcing speed and minimum maximum diffusion speed for the Krill's. Next, you can see here total number of parameters, that is the length of lower bound. In Krill-Hurd optimization algorithm, Krill's position is considered as the number of design variables, or you can say the number of dimension. So we will consider the number of dimension as the Krill's position. Now we will initialize the Krill's position in the search space. So first you can see Krill's position is 1, 2, total number of parameters, and here we have parameter that is the length of lower bound, that is 1 to 10. Here you can see we have 10, that is the total number of parameters, and 15, that is the dimension, as the Krill's position is considered as the number of dimensions. Here we have 15. So here you can see we have this equation. Using this, we can calculate the position values for Krill's in the search space. Right now, you can see here, this is the lower bound, and here, this is the upper bound. Rand is any uniformly distributed random value. So here you can see we have 15 dimension and 10, that is the total number of parameters. So you can see here for first row, first column, you can see the agent position is x11, lower bound, here you can see that is -10, upper bound, that is 10, and here you can see 0.2156, that is the random value. And we will put all the values in this equation, and one by one we can obtain the values for Krill's in the search space. That you can see here we have the values for the Krill's. Now you can see the position for the Krill's in the search space. Now you can see we have the search space and the position for the Krill's. Now using any cost function, we will calculate the fitness values, or you can say the objective function values for each Krill. And in this algorithm, Krill's position is considered as the number of dimension or design variables. So here we are using the sphere function to calculate the cost, or you can say the fitness value for the Krill's. And you can see we have the fitness values for 15 Krill's. Now in order to calculate the fitness value for the first Krill, put all the values here. You can see we will put all these values in this function, and you can see we obtain the value here. So one by one, you can see here we will calculate the fitness, that is 4.11424. Like that, we will put all the values, like for the second Krill, third, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, up to 15, 1 by 1 in this function. And you can see here we have the fitness values for each krill in the search space. In the krill herd optimization algorithm, the krill's position is considered as the total number of design variables, and it is according to the food location in the search space. So first you can see we will initialize all the important parameters. Then you can see here for the position initialization we can use this equation, and you can see the position for the krills in the search space. And after that we can use any cost function to calculate the fitness values for the krills, and you can see the fitness values computed using this cost function. So that's all about this video. If any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.